Okay, let's talk about Emily Ratajkowski. So, an article came out today on the Daily Wire, and it's titled, "That's Sexist." Emily Ratajkowski pegs internalized misogyny to women who think she's too sexy to read, so she's victim of it too. Now, Emily Ratajkowski, if you don't know, I think she's about 28 or 29. She's a model. She sort of got famous after she did a music video with Robin Thicke. It was a music video for the song Blurred Lines. I think it was like 2013, 2014, something along those lines. And it was her and two other models in the music video, and her and the other models, while Robin Thicke and Pharrell are kind of singing and doing their thing. They're dancing around them, naked, boobs out, like bouncing up and down, and yeah. So that's how she sort of got famous. And since then, I think she's done a few films. She has a huge social media presence, has been a very successful model. She's been a bit of a political activist. She was very vocal during the Kavanaugh hearings. I think she went to like a protest or something like that and posted pictures of it. She is a vocal Bernie Sanders supporter. And actually, this article in the Daily Wire is referencing an interview she gave with British GQ. And on the cover of that, she's wearing a Bernie Sanders t-shirt. She also sort of gained a lot of media attention for a picture she posted with Kim Kardashian a few years ago. Kim Kardashian posted a naked selfie of herself and got a lot of heat for it. So in response to that, her and Emily then posted a picture of both of them in the bathroom mirror topless, like flicking off the camera and basically saying like, F you. The ironic thing about this photo was the whole point of this photo was to be like a feminist message and to say like, no, F you, we're not gonna be ashamed of our bodies. But they clearly did it in like a some kind of like office building or business building. It was a public restroom, and they brought in a light, and you can see it. They brought in a freaking light to make sure they looked fabulous in the photo, which yeah, that's ironic. You're doing an F you, I don't care what you think photo, but then you have to make sure you look good. Doesn't make any sense. Again, the hypocrisy of modern day feminism. Okay, so I'm gonna read you a part of the article and then we'll talk about it. So this is the article in the Daily Wire. During an interview with GQ Britain published Thursday, model and left-wing activist Emily Ratajkowski talked about sexism and body image, noting that a female once underestimated her intellectual prowess because she's too sexy. That's sexist, Ratajkowski recalled, noting that this proves the theory of so-called internalized misogyny, a trap she's fallen victim to as well. I was confused by some people's reaction for a long time, people saying, you can't do all these things, Ratajkowski explained to GQ in relation to her aesthetics, pigeoning her in the mainstream. Oh, pigeonholing her in the mainstream. I apologize. It taught me a lot about sexism and misogyny in the world because the idea that a woman who looks a certain way or presents herself a certain way can't talk about politics or read books? Ridiculous, she said. Ratajkowski recalled a girlfriend of a reporter who once questioned if the model really read all the books she claimed to have read, apparently because of her looks. I remember in an interview I gave years ago, I mentioned I liked reading. And in the piece, the journalist explained how he went home to his girlfriend and she said to him, do you think she's really read all those books? I mean, that's sexism, Ratajkowski explained. Nowadays, someone would call that out. It just goes to show how deep some of our ideas about women run. You know, I fall victim of these ideas too, she explained, naming actress Demi Moore. This is interesting. I realized I made the assumptions about Demi Moore too, the 28-year-old said. I definitely wrote her off a little bit as an actress because she was so sexy, because she had that body, and I'm Emrata. So seriously, that's ironic. It just goes to show how deeply internalized misogyny is. Ratajkowski is a very beautiful woman. But Emily Ratajkowski, if you're watching this, people don't think you're not smart because you're beautiful. There are plenty of beautiful women who are very intelligent. People think you're not smart because of the way you present yourself. Because one, you're an avid Bernie Sanders supporter, and you are clearly a very well beneficiary of capitalism, and you're a business owner. So how can you support a socialist when you've had so much success via capitalism? Are you willing to give most of it up? I bet you're not. I don't know if she's aware, but I think it's only like 10% of Americans want socialism because we all know better, and not that many people actually support Bernie Sanders. It's a few amount of people that just happen to be very loud. What? There's something in my mouth. This is the problem with modern feminism, and this is the problem with identity politics. And this is why I get so passionate about it, especially when it comes to young girls. I used to work with young girls. I used to work in the government. And young girls, they look up to people like her. She, you know, she's famous, she's friend, whatever. Like, young girls look up to that, and then this is the message she's putting out there. The problem I have with modern feminism and identity politics is there is no personal responsibility. Zero. Instead of Emily being like, wow, I wonder why people treat me like this or why they question my intelligence. Maybe it's because I have bad ideas. No, she doesn't go to that. She goes straight to, it's because I'm a beautiful woman. No. People do not think you're dumb because you're a beautiful woman. People think you're dumb because of what you present to the world. If you look at Emily Ratajkowski's Instagram, it's all naked photos of her. She's basically putting out sex. Her whole image is sex, and that's what she puts out there. And that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. But when that's what you put out there, and then people maybe have an idea of you, and look, that wasn't even that offensive. She was never called a name. She never had, the woman just said, do you think she really read all those books? That's it. That's not very offensive. And instead of you looking at yourself and thinking about the image that you put out in the world, or instead of taking ownership of the image that you put out in the world, you blame it on everyone else. This is the problem with feminists. They want to have their cake and they want to eat it too. They want to say, I'm going to do whatever I want. I'm going to say whatever I want. I'm not going to care about, you know, society. I'm not going to care about the image I'm putting out. I'm just going to do whatever I want. I'm going to say whatever I want. And if you don't like it, F you, it's your problem. That's not how the world works. And that's why this is damaging to women. Because you can say that all you want, but at the end of the day, that is not how the world works. You get back from this world what you put out. You put that image out, you're going to get back the consequences of that. And it seems like her consequences really aren't that bad. And she's still yelling misogyny, sexism, instead of taking ownership. Instead of saying like, yeah, I can understand why some people think that. That's the image I put out there. But actually, I am a really smart girl and I do read books and this is who I am. Why don't you say that? Let's talk back about her comment she made about Demi Moore. You know, I fall victim to these ideas too, she explained, naming actress Demi Moore. I realized I made assumptions about Demi Moore too, the 28-year-old said. I definitely wrote her off a little bit as an actress because she was so sexy, because she had that body, and I'm Enrada. So that's seriously ironic. It just goes to show how deeply internalized misogyny is. It's not internalized misogyny, it's you. I grew up watching Demi Moore. I've seen all the same movies. I never thought she was less smart because of her body. I never thought she was less smart because she's a beautiful woman. And I never thought she was less smart because sometimes she played really sexy roles. Not once did that thought go through my head. Not once did I write her off like Emily Ratajkowski did. It sounds to me like you're the one with the problem, Emily, not everyone else. And this, again, goes back to the problem. See the lack of personal responsibility here? No, it's not her problem that she had these feelings. It's everyone else's problem. It's the world's problem. This is why celebrity culture is dying. This is why Donald Trump is gonna win again. what I would tell the girls I work with and what I would tell any young girl or any girl my age, it's okay to want to be sexy. It's okay to wear tiny clothes and to wear sexy things and to celebrate being sexy. I danced burlesque before, but you should always lead with talent. Lead with your brains, lead with talent, and have that be secondary. And someone like Emily, she completely leads with sex. And then it sounds like she doesn't like it when people make assumptions because of that. Well, you know what? That's how life works. That's how it is. And to go against that and to blame it on everyone else instead of looking at yourself, it is a huge mistake. And a lot of people don't completely respect girls like her on Instagram is because to show boobs, to show butt, and to take the sexy photos, that is the easy way to get followers. It is very easy to get followers and to get famous that way. Super easy. But to do it with brains and to do it with talent is way harder. And that is why people don't have the same amount of respect for people like her. And I think that a part of her maybe knows this somewhere inside of her and maybe doesn't like it, so she's trying to redeem that somehow. I don't know what's going on. But she's great, she's wonderful, she's beautiful, but the message that she is sending out is damaging, and it's completely misguided. Okay, that's all I have right now. See you later. Bye.